Activities of the 5th Special Forces were filmed during the period 15 to 22 February. Headquartered at Nha Trang, 40 kilometers north of Cameron Bay, Special Forces Logistics Support Command handles major maintenance of equipment and serves as a supply hub for a far-flung network of strategically located A camps throughout South Vietnam. This is a section of the headquarters supply depot. Materiel destined for remote outposts is delivered by air. Diesel fuel for camp generators is a critical item. So is fresh food, not only for the Special Forces A teams, but for the Vietnamese nationals who also live in the tactical camps. A 3-month supply of fresh meat and vegetables is being loaded aboard an Air Force C-123 for the camp at Phu Tuc. Livestock loading sometimes presents a problem, but the beef is scheduled for shipment, and that is that. Aircraft of all kinds make delivery runs to resupply Special Forces camps. Some of the larger aircraft cannot land at the camps and airdrop supplies. Day after day, the resupply flights are programmed out of the Special Forces headquarters. The A camp at Ple My, 40 kilometers south of Pleiku, is typical of these installations. It has a hard-packed dirt airstrip where logistic support planes skillfully land to deliver a full load of supplies. Without these periodic resupply deliveries, the camps could not operate in enemy territory. As the trucks are loaded, every item is checked to make sure nothing was forgotten. A different kind of delivery is made to Zam Cot. Here, a palletized 3/4-ton truck is airdropped from an Air Force C-130. The vehicle will be used to transport construction materials from place to place within the camp perimeter while the area is undergoing development. At Duc Co, 48 kilometers southwest of Pleiku, this Special Forces A camp is in full operation, mounting combat patrols against the Viet Cong and gathering intelligence on enemy infiltration. The camp's first line of defense is a woven barbed wire fence and claymore mine. A deep trench and zone of sharp bamboo stakes are next. Then come rolls of concertina barbed wire and an immobilized M41 tank. The camp's bunkers not only command broad fields of fire, but provide living quarters for the Montagnard troops. Sheltered platforms high in the trees serve as guard posts. This native fisherman repairing his net is one of the residents here. Bamboo sticks are being prepared for use in the building of a new house in the camp. Mostly Montagnard tribesmen, the villagers can build a new house in one day. The homes of these mountain people are of woven thatch and erected on pilings to keep them off the ground. During the rainy season, the area is a sea of mud. At the American-built community house, the camp's residents gather for sick call. The hard-working Special Forces medic handles patients with the help of an interpreter. Part of the Civic Action Program is a new dispensary where the specially trained medic can perform emergency operations. The strikers, as the native defense guards are called, make daily security patrols in the Duc Co area. They are trained and led by Special Forces personnel. these Montagnard troops are tough, quick to learn, and dependable. On their daily patrols, these men are alert and perceptive. If the Viet Cong are in the vicinity, the Montagnard's men seem somehow to know it. Here, they have located a hidden VC mine a few kilometers down the road from the camp. A special forces demolition man is called. A plastic explosive charge is rigged to dispose of the mine. While the charge is being prepared, the strikers scan the area on the alert for Viet Cong. The temperature is 100 degrees in the shade. The demolition man finishes his job, and the security patrol heads back to the A camp at Duck Cove.